Hi, everybody, and welcome to the Veedverks Bandit Gunman series. We are going ahead and going to get loaded in right here, right now. Join in, jump in with these boys as they go ahead and hit the high banks, high speeds of Texas Motor Speedway. It's been an exciting here first couple of weeks here at preseason. I'm going to go ahead and give these boys a minute to get loaded up, get their cars fired up, and get them rolling. Jump right on in here in the action as the boys get ready, take their pace lap, get lined up, and we'll go ahead and get a look, see where everyone's getting started for tonight's race. Tonight's race, as well as all the races this season, are brought to you by the people of Veedverks. If you need anything in the form of CBD oils, lotions, help you deal with pain, nausea, anything like that, go ahead, check out their website, Veedverks.com. That's Veedverks. And we want to thank them for going ahead and giving us a shot here. Take a look at these boys as they come off turn four, or off of turn two. I apologize. Getting ready to take the green flag. It looks like we've got the three car on pole outside. Row one is going to be the 42. Take a minute here. We got inside row two. It looks like it's the 28. Outside the 22. Inside row three will be the 74 car. Outside is the 5. Go ahead and give this camera a minute, swing around. Inside row six is the number two. Outside row six, or outside row four, I apologize, is the number one. Followed by the 98, bringing up the rear of the field. Come out of turn four, and you got the green flag is out, and the boys are underway. Going in turn one, looks like we are side by side here. As the three gets thrown on the inside. Looks like the 42 gets a little bit of a push from the 22 on the high side. He stalls out, three comes back hard on the inside, gets to clear, and takes the lead coming out of turn two. 42 is not giving up just yet, though, as he's getting the run back on the high side with help from behind from the 22 and the 28 cars. Field's stringing out a little bit now, except for the 42 and the 3 car, sitting there right there, bumper to bumper, coming out, and the 3 car is going to lead lap number one. Go ahead, let these boys get settled in here. And we'll get a lineup. Coming out of turn two, 42 takes a look inside of the three, settles back in line in between the three and the 22. First three cars are getting a little bit of a gap on the rest of the field here. 28 goes a little bit higher on the outside in turns three and four. Looks like that is the one car getting a run on the inside as they come to the line. The one will take this position, clears the 28 car. Eight comes under pressure from the two car now. Let's keep a eye on this, see if they settle it out or if they ride around. Yeah, it looks like the 28's putting up a little bit more of a challenge there. The two, a little bit of contact coming to three and four, but they all get it straightened up and settled in. Looks like things are settling down. Here we go. The 22 car is going to go ahead and take a run up on the high side as he tries to make a run. 22 making a run for the lead. Falls back second place on the high side. Now falls back to third place. And settle back in line. Try to get a run. Looks like the 28 gets the grass a little bit there. Runs high out of turn two, and the two car will get the spot. And the 22 is making another run up on the outside of the 42. It looks like this time we've got some help from the one as we get this battle for the lead intensifies. We have four cars right here under a blanket. It looks like every single one of them is not content to just ride around and let laps get busy. They want to go ahead, get after it, and get after it hard now. Three car moves up to the block. You see some momentum coming from the high side. 22 is staying right at it, though. It's the 42 took back down the line and behind the three car. One car moves down back to the low side behind the 42. Now back up high behind the 22. Back to the low side behind the 42. You're going to try to push the 42 up there past the 22 and get that run going up to go after the three car. And they are three wide coming out of turn two. We got 22 up high, 42 in the middle, and the one down low. Going into turn three, we are still three wide. 42 lifts a little bit. One car clears. Two people in one shot there in three and four, making a run now at three car. 22 is still not giving up there on the high side. He is dedicating himself to that. He says, you boys can go ahead and take the bottom. We're going to get this high side working. Sounds like we have somebody in the pits. Let's go take a look at pit road and catch it. And it is the 28 car coming out of the pits. Word from downstairs, this car is not handling right, so they decide to come in, make an early adjustment, see what they can get after it. Meanwhile, back up front, it looks like the one was making a run on the high side on the 3 for the lead, and the 23 went up to block, and the 22 is there. Boys, you got four cars under a blanket here. Now the 22 gives the bump back. Bumpered a little bit to the three car, moves him up the track. Going into turn three here, we are three wide again for second place. Get a move, buddy. Looks like things settled down, but then again in this race, what is settled down? We have still got four cars under a blanket, two by two by two, and nobody wants to settle in. Now this is some good racing, folks. If you don't like it, I don't know what you like. We got a battle for the lead here between the 22 and the three car, still going at it since lap number one. 22 looks like he is finally making that high side work. Gets the good run coming out of turn two. It looks like he is going to pull ahead coming down the back stretch. Going into turn three. Is he going to clear him? Yes, he is ahead of him going into turn three, but three comes right back in on the inside again. Turn right through the middle there, even. Here comes a big run on the outside from the 22. Is three going to block? No, he doesn't have room to close the door. The 22 gets the run back by him from the high side. Coming across the line. They're dead even at the line. 22 sails it in there up high. 3 is sailing it in there down low with some help from the 42. It looks like they're going to clear him. That 22 is not wanting to give up. Oh, it looks like the 3 car is going to the pits. Or is he going to just get out of shape there? It looks like he just got out of shape. He is back up on the track. And we have a new leader for the first time in tonight's race. We have the 22. And Corey 21-14 taking the lead and going to the point. It looks like the 42 car ducks off into pit road. I believe that is going to be an illegal pit entry as he came in off of turn number 4 instead of coming in through the apron in 3 and 4, which would be a commitment line violation. We're just waiting on confirmation from race control on that, but it looked from our cameras he just came in down low off of turn 4. It's Roll Tide 69. That's weird. We are watching the 42 as he gets word at this time that he has a drive-through penalty. Indeed, that was a commitment line violation. And this time by the flag stand, he's catching the black flag. So per NASCAR rules, he has 3 laps to get that drive-through done. Otherwise, his car will no longer be getting scored. But we will have to wait and see what happens with that. We'll keep our camera strained on him, however. Like the one stick takes a look to the outside of the 42 as he's riding and see what he's going to do. Okay. All right. We are getting word from race control that the 42's entry was clean. He had gotten onto the apron, slid back up. So we will look at it post-race, but as it looks right now, he is clear. We'll go ahead and catch back up here to the battle up front and take a look. Oh, it looks like the 3 has gotten back around the 22 car. As they come down the backstretch heading into turn 3. 22 ducks the inside out of 3, takes the spot, goes back around in front. Really not much of a challenge there, folks. It looks like the boys have pretty much settled into the run. We have the 98 on pit road. He comes out. Not much has changed up front. 22 and the 3 are still out there, it looks like. Just seem to be pretty content to just ride around, log laps, and let the race come to them. They understand it's early, and after the way the truck series went, they had some technical difficulties in it that ended up calling the race prematurely. But it was definitely one of the more rough and tumble type nights for them. They would seem like they would start to get going, but then something would end up happening and cause some problems for some people. They were back under yellow, so the boys have been eager to get back up on track tonight and try to get some racing laps in. We're going to go ahead and take a short break here for a moment, and we'll be back shortly. We are back as they come here to complete stage one. It looks like the 22 is going to take the stage win as the 3 gets into the wall. We are just waiting for confirmation on that. All right, as these boys get ready to make their pit stops, we'll go ahead and we'll take a short break. And we will be back for the start of stage 2. We are back here as we get ready for the start of stage number 2. And it looks like we're going to have 22, the 3, the 2, the 5, the 42, 28, 74, 98, and 1 will be the lineup as they take the green. The 22 gets to jump on the inside, pulls along the 2 with him, and the 42, 74. The outside row starting to get a run back, but nope, inside row looks like it's going to prevail as the first 4 cars are going to clear the 3 car who started on the front row on the outside. Coming down the back stretch, 22-42, move to the top side of the racetrack. 2-74, stay down low. 3 is going to try to split the middle as they go 3 wide for third position back there in the middle of the pack. We're going to turn 4, still 3 wide, and we have some contact. 3 goes into the grass, and what a hell of a save he makes coming down the front stretch. It looks like 28 got into the grass, and we will go back and see if he was able to gather it up. Looks like he gathers it up, gets going again. Same thing with a 98. They keep him running, so we stay green. Meanwhile, back up here at the front of the track pack, we have the 22 is currently in the lead, and the 2 are in second place. 42 third place. 22 drifts high. 2 and 42 make it 3 wide coming out of turn 4, coming across the line. We're back 22-2 inside outside with the 42 taking a look middle of the track going in. Turn 1, he ducks back down low behind the 40. The 42 ducks down low behind the 2 car. Coming out of turn 2, the 42 pops out down the bottom, 3 wide again, looking down, going into turn 3, and he's gonna keep it in. No, he's gonna left again. Back down 2 wide, 22 inside, outside, 2 inside. 42 takes another peek inside, coming out of turn 4. This time it looks like, nope, still no run. He is trying like hell, folks. 2 car clips the grass, coming down the front stretch, going into turn 1, drifts up a little bit. They are 3 wide for second place with a 22, 42, 3. Inside, outside, inside, middle, and inside. And on the back stretch, we are still 3 wide as they head into turn number 3. 42 dropping back. He falls all the way back from second place to fifth place. And one straightaway. 2 car now out front. 22. Oh, okay. Scoring update. He is not on the lead lap, so that was not a battle for position. Meanwhile, up front, however, we still have the 2 out front. We're now the 3 looking on the inside, and 22 up running that high side all night long. We know where he likes to be. And 42 is coming. Is he coming into? Nope. He's back on track. He must have had an issue where he had to slow down a little bit. But it looks like everything is good. He's moving on back up. Back up here at the front, we have the 2 and the 3 battling side by side going into turn 1. The 22 finally gets pushed out of that front row. And we have the 3, the 1, and the 5 lined up on the inside. And the 2, the 22 lined up on the outside. 74 drops down on the inside behind the 5 car. Tries to suck right up on the draft with them. And should pick up 2 spots at the same time as he does that and see if he can't get some track position going. Turn 4, 3 drifts up a little bit. 1 moves up a little bit higher. Tries to take that run up there going with him. He's got the 2 and the 22 with a big push coming up from behind there. Door to door going into turn number 1. Coming out of turn number 2, we are 2 by 2 by 2. 3 rows, 2 by 2 all the way down. We've got the 1 on the outside of the 3 car trying to take that momentum, use it to carry him up to the lead. We've got the 5 down low in row number 2 with the 2 on the outside. 74 inside, 22 on the outside in row 3. Coming out of turn 4, we are still door to door, neck and neck. As they come across the line, who will lead this lap? It will be the 3 car by an inch. There's 5 car right behind the 3. As Jaywood tries to use that run and make it 3 wide coming through the middle. Nope, he's going to follow back the line behind the number 3 of Riot. Number 1 Motorsports gets that run up on the high side. 5 car jumps upside with him. Tried to go ahead, push his teammate up there. Meanwhile, the 4th place car is on back and falling back a little bit. 3 car and the 5 car make a little bit of contact there. And 3 car out. He thought about making a pit stop. Pulled it right back up there on track. Catches back up with the field. There will be no penalty on that. Meanwhile, up front, we have the number 1 car with a big lead over the rest of the field. 5 car falls in behind line behind him, followed by the 74 of Duke Boy, 22 of Corey, 21-14, the 2 car of IROC. And who do we have behind IROC? We have the 42, who is a lap car of Roll Tide. Looks like things have settled up for the leader as he got a lucky break there. We'll go ahead and fall back a little bit through the field. We've got 5 car running here in second place. He's had a pretty solid night. Started out a little bit off the pace, right, just kind of riding in the first stage. But here in the second stage, it's come alive. And there we have a battle for third place between the 74 and the 22. It's the 22 and the 2 both get a big run on the inside. Take it down low past the 74. Okay. All right, we have a correction. The 74 is a lap down as well. So that was not a battle for position on the track. The scoring, however, was a battle for track position, and the 22 and the 2 have been working together great all night long as they try to make a run back up through the field and try to pick those spots back up, get back up to the front. It's been a dominant night, mainly by the 22 and the 3 through the first stage, as they went ahead and they got hooked up and they checked out and got on their own strategy and were able to use it to pull ahead and take the first stage. However, since the second stage has started, it has been all about the number 1 and the number 5 cars. And They're showing they got some power under their hoods tonight. They're going ahead. The number one is checked out to a nice little bit of a lead here. Number five is not far behind him. 28 car that has had a few issues tonight. Three car with... No, you have to be on the apron going into turn three. And stay on the apron through three and four. Alright, here we have the three car. It looked like he had a slip up in the middle of turns three and four earlier that put him on the apron. And he realized he couldn't go into the pits. Either that or he had overshot his entry. So he cost him some track position. Luckily, though, he's got this end of the second stage not too far out. Here we have the 42, and he's had a couple of issues tonight, but still soldiering along, riding along. And we have the 28. He has had a few issues of his own tonight. Went for a ride through the grass, but he was able to keep it straight. But car looks like it's handling better now. He's going able to pretty much keep pace with that three car up in front of him. So gets a couple of good breaks tonight. He gets a couple of good breaks tonight, and he can go ahead, he can pick up some spots, and find himself back in contention. Moving up, we have the... moving back up through the field, we have the 22 as he battles with the 2 car for third place. They've been pretty much just riding all night long, and trying to get their spots, getting themselves set up, getting ready for that final stage. We're going to go ahead and pause for a moment here and take a break, and we'll be back for the end of stage two. And we are back here at the Veedverks Bandit Grand National Series race here at Texas for preseason week number two. When we pick our broadcast back up, we see the number one car is still up here in the lead, followed by the number five car. We're just waiting for a quick update from scoring to see where we are at in relation to the end of the stage. And once we get that, we'll be able to go ahead and send it to you. Oh, we are on the final lap of the stage, it looks like, so we came back just in time as we have the number one car running in first, followed by the number five. And following behind them, we are going to the wrong menu. Looks like we have the 22 after the 5, followed by the 2. And we have the 98, the 42, the 74. Oh, no, I'm sorry, we have the 3, and 98, 3, 42, 74. And 28. We'll go ahead and we'll take a moment as they ride around under caution. And take a look. Just give you a little bit of the history of us. We were started out a few years ago and started out on PlayStation 3 running on Wednesday nights. And we started expanding after Season 2 at the start of Season 3 where we brought in to Wednesdays and Thursdays, and then in Season 4 we expanded all three series. Now we're going to go ahead, we're going to watch a lot of these drivers, are long time drivers that have been around for a while, and then we have some rookies that have come around this year, and it's going to be a new big year. We have lots of things going again with the people at Veedverks going ahead and offering us an opportunity to join as partners with our league and see how things go as we look towards a good future together. And it sounds like the caution's just getting ready to wrap up. And we are getting ready to start the third and final stage and see who's going to go ahead and take it all. It looks like the updated lineup is going to be the number one on the inside of row one. Outside will be the five. Inside of row two is going to be the 22. Outside of him will be the 3, followed by the 22, 74, 28, 98, and 42. And they are green for the start of stage 3 as we go ahead and see who can take it off. Going into turn 1, the number 1 gets the jump, followed by the 2. The whole inside lane gets that big run again. Looks like we had some slight contact there between the 74 and the 3, and it turns into some major contact. We are hearing there is caution out on the track.
I'm sorry, guys. I couldn't get slowed down in time. I was in the very back and ended up running into that red car there. Got to pass me. I'm sorry about that.
We're waiting to hear who's going to be the 3 pass car.
I was involved in the
car. All right. We're waiting for the field to go ahead and get straightened out.
I don't know, I'm a lap down. I'm 2 laps down from the leaders.
Pits will be open this time, so we will go ahead and we'll see who will be taking that. We'll see who goes ahead and takes a chance to make some adjustment, make some strategy, and make an extra stop. And who stays out here as they go ahead and come up towards the commitment line. God.
I mean, I'm like 2 laps down. I'm a lap down from the guys that aren't even doing any good.
Okay, his pits are open. We will see who is going in. Looks like the 1 is going to stay out. The 2 is going to stay out. And everybody else is going to go in. Take a short break while they go ahead and make their pit stops, and we'll be back after this as they get ready for their restart.
It's ridiculous. How does nobody get a lead lap around?
One to go.
That's so fucked. That's so fucked. I'm the 98, but I'm 2 laps down.
Here,
We are coming down the back stretch on one to go.
Well, I was like the third car involved in it then, so what about me? I said I was the third. Who comes up with this shit?
This time. Alright, we are getting word. It's one to go at the line. Back as we are coming down the back stretch on one to go, getting ready to get back at it, see how it plays out for the rest of these boys. Hopefully you've enjoyed the race tonight, as there has been a lot of on-track action, plenty of good hard race and lots of battle and some strategy that's thrown a few people a few loops. We've gotten some things mixed up, but all the boys are back at it. Coming out of turn four, getting ready to go back green. Let's go ahead and settle in and watch the cars and stars and listen to the sounds as these boys go at it. Put the pedals to the metal.
I'm loose as fuck. I tighten it up and it's still loose.
As we come back, we have the number one leading and 22 followed behind him in second place, followed by the 42 in third, 3 car in fourth, 5 car in fifth. 6 car in line that we see there is the number 22, or number 2 of IROC Z, followed by the 74 of Duke Boy 1524, making his Xfinity debut here in preseason as he takes over the driver role for yours truly, Scooby G. Following him on track, we see the 28 car. At tail of the field is the 98. He goes ahead and he rides, waiting on his shot to get his chance to get the free pass or be able to take the wave around if everybody else was pit ahead of him. Meanwhile, it looks like things have kind of settled down here. We got boys just riding around. It's all kind of spread out. Nobody really pushing anything.
Free passes are illegal. Okay.
It looks like the 22 is getting a run here on the 1 as he peeks on the outside a little bit. Ducks back in line, coming out of turn 4, back on the outside.
Hey, look, man, I don't know the rules. I'm just going to go with what I did what you said. All right.
Yeah. And he's going to try to carry that run again. Oh, it's a little bit of contact there going into turn 1, but they separate. Everybody keeps them straight.
I mean, I did
back
that,
on the outside.
Well, not everybody did, but the game like this.
As they come out of turn 2, down the back stretch, going into turn 3, the 22 is not giving that high side up. He is in love with it tonight. He is right. Keeping his car running up there, which is a very big surprise, because anyone that's watched this man drive for a while knows he's always been a bottom feeder. He loves hooking his car around that white line, but not tonight. Tonight, he is. They all say you cannot make the top groove at Texas work. He is saying, watch me. As he goes around, and he is just second lane or higher all night long. Number one goes ahead and gets a good run coming out of turn two. That time, though, goes ahead and puts a couple car lengths up on the 22. As they go into turn three, distance looks about the same. We're going to go ahead and drop back a little bit here in the field. We're going to catch up with the battle between the 3, the 5, and the 42 cars. As they go and come across the line, I'll notice the tail going to turn one. Let's see if they fan out like they've been doing the last few laps. Nope, everyone stays in line. Goes ahead and we're just going to ride around. Nope. three car drifts up a little bit coming out of turn two. Five ducks to the inside, takes a look. Nope, nothing there. He just falls back in line going into turn three. Coming through turn straight and four there. Still in line. Three looks like he clips the apron a little bit. Five's peeking on the outside this time. Nope, no, nothing there, but he takes that run. He's going to peek on the inside, back to the outside. Coming to the line, he follows back in line. We have three cars running nose to tail, and not one of them can make a mistake because the next one's there ready to pounce. As they come through turns one and two, the five keeps peeking on the outside, taking a look at that three. Now he ducks to the inside, coming out of turn two, going down the back stretch. This is the 42 going to go with. Is he going to go ahead and stay up high and run with the three, or is he going to duck down and help the five and push him inside? It looks like he's going to duck down with the five. They get a good run through turns three and four, as the five is going to get his nose just ahead of the three, and it looks like the 98 is out of shape on the front.
The worst time for this to happen.
And is everyone going to save it? Yes. Oh, my. I cannot believe they all kept those cars going straight.
I cannot fucking believe how loose this car is right now.
Wow. That's all you can say about that one, folks. Great driving by all those guys as they were battling for position. And it looks like the one that gets the heavy hit is the 5 car of Jay Wood, though. And he falls all the way back to 5th position. Looks like they're all settled back down. Oh, we are heavier and some problems for the 28 as we see him in the, through the grass. And meanwhile, back up front, as we're waiting to hear what happened with the 28, meanwhile, back up front, we have the 22 making a pass on the 3. As the 1 has checked out to a huge lead over the rest of the field. And we have the 22, the 42, the 2, and the 3 all battling with the 3 hung back there at 5th position. But if he doesn't make any mistakes, this is one's car to race to lose tonight, folks. He has just gotten out front, and ever since stage 2, when he got out in front, he has just checked out and been top of the field. It's been either that 1 car or that 5 car. 22's got the speed, it just doesn't seem like he can get in the right position to go ahead and take advantage of it. And, yep, it looks like things have settled down, so we're going to go ahead, we're going to take pause for a few seconds for some commercial break. Go ahead, catch a breather, and let these guys get ready to make their green flag pit stops. They should be just ahead or around the corner. Looks like green flag pit stops are beginning as we saw the 74 coming into the pits. We jump back onto our leader. He's still on track. Go ahead and take a quick look through the field. See if he's on track. And he's getting ready to pit. It's a 98. Looks like he is really loose coming through turns 1 and 2. That car is just looks evil. And we have the 3 car going into pit road. Making his green flag pit stop. 42 still on track. 28 on track. 22 on track. And he'll probably be one of the last people to pit, as he is very well known for getting excellent fuel mileage out of his cars. He definitely gets everything out of the last drop. And here we see the 42, the 5 are also still out here on track. 2 car makes his way down pit road. We'll go ahead and see how he does. Clean entry in. The 1 car back up. Our leader on track. Go ahead, we'll take a quick break while pit stops cycle out, and we'll be back after that. And we are back with Green Flag Pit Stop. We're just about finishing up, and surprise, surprise, look who stayed out and has not pitted yet. Who guessed it? That number 22 of Corey. He's always known to try to go that extra mile when it comes to gas and get every single drop out of the car as he can. And as we say that, here he comes going into the pit road. Looks like he cooks a little hut there, gets it right up there to the edge, right next to that line. And the goes ahead, keeps it on the apron, and it's going to be a clean entry coming into the pits. We'll go ahead and see how his crew does, and we will go ahead and see where he cycles out into the field. Here we have the number 28 of Cracker coming back out on track as he's getting up to speed through turns 1 and 2. Goes ahead, pushes it right up there towards that edge of that limit as well as he comes out. Not quite as close to the line as Corey did, but it's a nice, good, clean entry coming back out onto the track. And it should cycle the lead back around to the number one of motorsports here. We'll cycle, work our way through the field to him. There we are. And then we have the change of the lead as motorsports goes around the 22, gets back into the top spot. Comes back up, and he's starting to catch the 28 of Cracker, the 98 just up ahead of him. We'll go ahead and we'll watch him, give him a chance to work his way through some lap traffic here. Here we are, we jump on board as we ride along with him. Gotta love that, folks. They went ahead, they moved on over, gave them plenty of room.
Yes, sir, absolutely.
Go right on ahead there, sir. You got it. You got it a lot quicker than us right now. You gotta love that courtesy from the folks. We'll go ahead further back. We have a three car moved up.
I really didn't mean to rush anybody earlier. I'm very sorry about everything.
42 running in fourth. The 5 has moved up into fifth, followed by the 22, dropped back to sixth position. Looks like
I wish that was real.
Be following behind a 7, followed by the 28, and then the 98 bringing up the rear. Looks like right here, it's a 2nd through 6, they're getting to tighten back up a little bit. We got the numbers 5 and 22 sitting there running nose to tail, nice and tight, trying to catch up to that 3 car pack of the 3, the 2, and the 42. And we'll see if they're going to go ahead and say, all right, we're going to line up together and ride and see if we can't catch this number one car, or if we're going to go ahead and nope, the number 22 has other ideas. He says, I am sticking my nose out there. I am making a run to the high side. I want to go. And he goes ahead, stays up high, but the 5 drops down low behind the 42 as he goes ahead, and the 42 starts to get a run on the 2. His head takes a look. 2 closes the door, says, no, you are not taking this spot. I am going to stay right here. But 42 forces his way in there. Then is the 2 going to close the door again? Yes, he closes the door. Wow, that was tight. He really couldn't get much closer than that. And here comes the 22. Surprise, surprise. He's running up high. And the 5 is going to get the road down low. That 42 is going back and forth. He says, I don't know which way to go, but they are coming from both sides. And I'm going to do everything I can to try to block him. We are 2-3 wide for a moment coming out of turn 2, but right back down to 2 wide as they go in. That number 2 is glued to that back bumper, that number 3, but do they have enough time? That 1 has opened up a huge lead over the rest of the field. He says, you guys go ahead and keep racing it out. I am going to check out. And these guys are not giving an inch. 5 going ahead, getting a run underneath the 22. Is he going to clear him this time? No, the 22's... The rest of the field pack slides up. That's what they've done every time down the straightaway. Down the corners, they drop down low and pull the 5 along. Up on the straightaway, they pull up high and pull the 22 along. Now it looks like the 42 is going to drop back a little bit more to get right on the front bumper. The 5 get a good run and a good push coming up. 3 and 4 cut down the front stretch. Nope, 2 wiggles a little bit there in the middle, 1 and 2. Pushes the 22 up to the higher side, and they are four wide for a moment coming out of turn two. Funnel it back down to 2x2 as they go into turn three. 98 giving them plenty of room up there on the high side. God, these guys do.
That's what I'm saying about my goddamn car, man. I can't do it. I don't know. I thought I was going to do better. I wish the truck series would have continued because I was doing better in the trucks, which is not usual.
Looks like the 22 is going to make that high side work. He has come all the way from the back. He is coming around to the front. It's a three ducks off going back into pit road. Apparently we are
back. My race is already fucked, so I might as well let you guys go anyway. I'm 4 laps up and down. There ain't no way I'm doing anything.
Follow the 42, the 5, the 2.
I'm gonna race. I'm gonna try to keep you guys off me when I can, but once you get up to me, I'm gonna let you go.
42 follows him in behind. 5, the 2.
Fuck everybody else. I'm 4 laps down. Alright. Good racing
one
still.
One car continues to lead, riding right there behind the 74. Yep. Two is in the pits, 22 coming out of the pits, 28 is on track, 74 looks like he's getting ready to pit. 5 is still out here on track, 2 is still out here on track. 98 heading to pit road.
Just focus on one series from now on instead of multiple series because I'm running all three series and it's not helping.
Two car also coming down the pit road, 5 car stayed up. We should inherit the lead here. Go ahead and we'll ride and stay on board to show you just how tricky this pit road entry is. Looks like he's not ready to pit just yet, so we're going to have to cycle through the field to put up to where everyone is running at on track. Looks like the 22 is starting to catch the 1, so once the 5 goes ahead and makes his pit stop, that should be a battle for the lead. And that 5 car is saying, I'm going to show you how far I can go on the tank. Alright, we're getting word from downstairs that My car is going to be coming into the pits. Let's go ahead and jump on board. We're going to show you, boys and girls out here, just how hard this entrance is coming into pit road and why these guys are the best at what they do out here. Look at this. He keeps this right up tight towards the wall. It's drift out just a little bit to come in. You can't get much more pretty of an entry than that. That was a nice, clean, smooth come around that corner. Right set dead center on there. Go ahead and jump back out here to the field. Catch back up in this battle for the lead here. Here we are. We jump back up the lead. We have the one car just up there ahead of the number 22 as they come through turns 3 and 4. Looks like he's got about half a second lead over the 22 car as they go in. Five car just now coming out of pit road. He'll rejoin the field. You know the driver of that number one car is going to be smiling in there, folks. He was the winner here last season, and he just loves this track. It's always been one of his favorites, and he has not missed a mark all night long. 22 fell back a little bit there in the second stage in the mid part of the race, but he seems to be right back in there and right back in the zone. And he says, nope, I'm not letting you drive away with it just yet, but here we are. We're just getting down the last handful of laps here. Getting down here right now towards the end of it. This next time by, we will have just 5 laps left to go here in this Bandit Grand National race presented by Veedverks. And it has been one thriller. We have had lots and lots and lots of green flag action, lots of strategy thrown up there with those stages added in, plus a couple of cautions early on. And ever since we got to the start of stage 2, this has really been the motorsports show. He has gone ahead ever since he got out in front, and he has just checked out.
Take me below.
And it looks like Corey was starting to make some gains there on him in the number 22 Ford. But it seems like he's kind of stalled out now.
Really got nothing for anybody tonight.
That car just hooked up. He has not missed a mark all night long. Coming to the line this time as they come through turns 3 and 4, we were coming to 4 laps to go. Is he going to go ahead and begin his preseason here at Texas the way he ended his regular season at Texas? Looks like it. It's going to take a lot to go ahead and throw that number one car off the bounds. But never, never, never count Corey out. He has been known to make some serious runs in late race charges before, and he could be poised to do it again. You never know until the checker flag flies. Coming to the line, we have 3 to go this time.
Be a lot of this this season. Be a lot of me not knowing the tracks. There's only a few tracks that I do know.
Sports as he goes ahead and makes the run coming through turns 3 and 4. This time by, there will just be 2 laps to go, folks. So pretty much the way it runs, and the next flag ends the race, whether we get the white flag or the checkered yellow flag. It's just a matter of time. Coming through into turn 1 with 2 to go. We have the number 1 car followed by the 22. It looks like the 98 gets a little bit out of shape coming out of turn 2. Going into turn 3, he's got about a half a straightaway late up there on the number 1 car. As they come through turns 3 and 4, this time we'll be coming to the white flag for the number 1. About a half a straightaway behind the number 1 is the number 2, 22 of 4. I'm gonna do I'm just doing fucking awful. And two for the final
I'm doing so
time
fucking awful. It's not even funny.
Two,
I did not anticipate this at all. I anticipated
this
a good race.
It. As long as he hits his marks and doesn't hit the wall, we got the, our next winner.
I did better in the trucks. I never do. I fucking never do good in trucks. I mean, what the fuck?
We have the number one, one main motorsport, one main financial Chevrolet motorsports taking the checkered flag. Coming across the line second.
A good race, everybody.
Number 22, of course. 21-14. It looks like we're going to have a battle to the line for third between the 3 and the 5. And the 3 is going to get it, followed by the 5 of Daywood. Coming out of turn 4, we have the number 42 coming up to take fourth place. Looks like 6 is going to go to the number 28, 7th to the 74, 8th to the... I believe 8th will be to the 98th. We will have official scoring. And I want to thank you all for joining us here as we watch the preseason week number 2 for the Veedverks Bandit Grand National Series here at Texas, 150-miler. We had luck, a little bit of difficulties here earlier tonight on the Gunman Truck Series race. It caused that to be called early due to some technical difficulties, but boy, did they make up for it tonight here in the Bandits race. It has been one hell of a show, and we hope you will join us next week as we go ahead and continue to bring the ride to you as we move to Short Track Week. It will be the Cup Outlaws. We'll be racing that Richmond Raceway. The Gunman Trucks will be going to the Paperclip Half Mile at Martinsville, and the Bandit Grand National Series will be going at it once again at Iowa Motor Speedway. Please, everyone, make sure you tune in and join us, and we will see you all on the racetrack.